These two machines have same compatibility as between you and your toxic ex. I won't suggest you to connect back with your ex. However, you can connect Mac and Windows over Wi-Fi to transfer files between them. First, let's go to the Windows computer and make sure both devices are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Otherwise, it won't work. You have to connect both devices on the same Wi-Fi network. Then on your Windows PC, go to Menu, then Settings. Go to Network and Internet option. Wi-Fi and then connected Wi-Fi network, and here you have to select a network profile. Choose the private network profile, otherwise you won't be able to share files from your PC, so it is recommended to select the private network only. And if you have selected any manual IP or DNS, then it will still work, but if you select automatic IP and DNS, then you won't face any problem, you won't get any errors. Now let's go back to Network and Internet option, Advanced Network Settings, and then Advanced Sharing Settings. Expand the private network profile and make sure network discovery, file and printer sharing is turned on. If these settings are turned off, you have to turn it on first. Now we need to create a shared folder or share an existing folder so that we can transfer files between Mac and PC. Now I will create a new folder on the desktop, but you can create it anywhere on any location, or you can share entire disk partition. So let's create a new folder and name it something, Mac shared, whatever you like. Let's put some files into this new folder. I will just copy some files to this new folder. And now you have to share this folder on the network. Just select the folder and right click on it. Go to Properties and Sharing tab. Click on Advanced Sharing and check Share this folder. You can name the share folder anything you want, and then a maximum number of users. You can select it to 1, 2 or 3, but by default it is 20. Now click on Permissions. Here you can assign the permissions for the network user. By default, read is selected. That means you can just copy from the shared folder. You cannot write anything on this folder. Or you can enable the full control if you want to copy, paste and delete the files in that folder, and choose it for the everyone. Now hit apply and OK. Apply and OK again. And click on close. If you want, you can share any other folders like your documents, videos, downloads or anything. In my case, I create videos on this PC and edit on Mac. So I have to often share files from my videos folder to the Mac computer. What I can do is I will just share the videos folder and I will access it on the Mac. I will go to this PC, local disk C, users, user account, and then videos folder. Just right click on it, go to properties, sharing tab, and then advanced sharing. Enable the sharing option and change the permission to full control. Hit apply, OK, and close all the dialog boxes. And you can do this for any folder or disk partition. Now let's go to search and search for CMD and open it as admin. Click on the yes option, you will get on this screen. Now on the CMD, you just have to type ipconfig. Type ipconfig and press enter. You will get the IPv4 and IPv6 addresses for all the network adapter if they are connected. But we are just looking for the local Wi-Fi network adapter. Find the wireless LAN adapter Wi-Fi and look for the IPv4 address. So you just have to find the IPv4 address of your PC and note it down. And also you need to know the username and password of the Windows computer. In this case, itechfever.pc is the username and I know my password. If there is no password on the Windows PC, you have to create it first, otherwise it won't work. Alright, now let's go to the Mac computer and make sure it is connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Now open the Finder and click on the Go option at the top. And click on connect to server. Now you have to type here smb:// and the local IPv4 address of your Windows PC which you noted in the last step. So provide that IPv4 address and then click on connect. Now it will ask for the username and password. You have to provide the username of your Windows PC, not the Mac computer. So just provide the username of your Windows PC. I will provide my username. If there is any space, you have to enter that as well. And then password. Click on remember this password in my keychain so that you don't have to enter password every time, and then click on connect. Now it will ask you to select the shared folder and mount it on your Mac computer. I will use this one which I recently created, Mac shared, and these are other folders which are shared on the network. So I will select Mac shared and click on OK. Now you will find that shared folder along with the Macintosh HD and other disk partition on your Mac. Now you can easily access the shared folder on your Mac, copy and paste any files from this folder to your Mac or from your Mac to this folder. Or if you want, you can directly share any files to your iPhone over the AirDrop as well from the shared folder. You just have to click on share and share it over the AirDrop on your iPhone or any other Mac computer. And the transfer speed depends on the local Wi-Fi network connection, not the internet connection. So it is quite fast over the local Wi-Fi network. You can also copy files from your Mac to shared folder and access it on the Windows PC. For example, I copied some files and paste it on the shared folder. And if I access that shared folder on PC, you can see that I got those files which I copied from the Mac. So you can easily transfer files from your Mac to PC as well. Now if you click on the mounted network location, then you will find all the shared folder on that computer. So you can access those shared folder from here as well, or you can go to the network and open the connected computer and access the files. So there are multiple ways to access your shared folder on your Mac computer. Now, if you are disconnected by any chance or shut down your computer and want to connect back again, then you just have to click on go option and then connect to server and just click on connect. It will pre-fill the IP address, and once you connect, you just have to mount the location and then you can easily access the shared folders. One more thing you should know, that this is a one-way connection to transfer files between your Mac and PC. Like if you want to access the files from your PC on the Mac, then you can easily access using the shared folder. But if you want to transfer files from your Mac to PC, then you have to copy it on the shared folder first. However, you can create two-way connection to access any Mac files on your PC. We will mount the Mac drive on the PC. But that is for the next video. So this is how you can transfer files between your Mac and PC over the Wi-Fi network. And that's all for this video, guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos, and I will see you in my next video.